1957, Ingmar Bergman's The Seventh Seal, an allegorical tale about the age-old struggle between good and evil, debuted on the world stage. In the lead role of the ascetic knight, Bergman cast a young Swedish actor named Max von Sydow.
Varför vill du spela schack med mig?
Det är min sak.
Det har du rätt I.
Villkoret är att jag får leva så länge jag står emot. Spelar jag det matt, friar du mig.
Von Sydow's gaunt visage painted a character made doubtful and weary from years of bloodshed, but capable of staring down death itself.
Du ser ängslig ut. Döljer du något?
Ingenting undgår dig, eller hur?
Ingenting undgår mig. Ingen undgår mig.
This expert gamesmanship, the ability to execute the perfect play in his performances, has been the mark of Max von Sydow's entire career. He became an international star in 11 Bergman films, serving as a perfect conduit for the master director's raw spiritual journey. In films such as The Virgin Spring and Hour of the Wolf, von Sydow embodied Bergman's intangible intersection of art and spirituality, the anguish and pain of the masculine artist in crisis. But he was not just a pawn. Coming from the same national cinema that launched Greta Garbo, von Sydow understood instinctively the power of the close-up, that the subtlest gestures allow the audience to burrow deep into a character, to reconcile the illusion of cinema with higher truths learned of the real world.
You clearly recognized the utter hopelessness of the human condition.
Faith, optimism, the illusion that our spiritual strivings mean something.
In 2012, von Sydow received his second Academy Award nomination for Extremely Loud and Incredibly Close, an emotionally wrenching story set in post-9/11 New York City. Von Sydow's character speaks not a single word, but he gives voice, ironically, to a pain that cannot be expressed. Much was made, justly, of von Sydow's silent performance in that film, but he had already performed silently in 1958's enigmatic The Magician, known originally as The Face. In 1973's enormous box office hit, The Exorcist, von Sydow is an aged priest, slowed down by years of spiritual battle, a character not too far removed from the knight in The Seventh Seal, when he makes a final stand against unspeakable evil. His lullingly deep, resonant voice flanks our expectations in the contest over a little girl's soul. In this film, and many others, von Sydow is a master of making a film his own with relatively little screen time. In 3 Days of the Condor, von Sydow plays a methodical assassin affably, as an unassuming businessman hiding in the mundane light of day.
They didn't know you'd be here. I knew you'd be here.
It's a fascinating performance in a defining film of the 1970s. Over the last 30 years, von Sydow's unpredictable career continues to defy expectations. He has taken part in varying camps of science fiction, cult comedy classics.
I would say, without a doubt, that they suffer from paranoid schizophrenia.
Important films from Steven Spielberg, Martin Scorsese, and Woody Allen, and earned his first Academy Award nomination in Pelle the Conqueror. For 6 decades, in nearly 150 films since 1949, in productions for a dozen different countries that span a multitude of genres, he has attained the endgame rank of grandmaster. With astonishing range and unlimited versatility, there is no bind Max von Sydow cannot break. Checkmate.